we did the whole lash adjustment, and we know the compression is bad pretty much on cylinders 2 through 5. So everything except for the front of the engine. It could also be timing, but I did a cursory check on the timing marks to make sure they lined up with top dead center. And from what I can tell, the engine is timed properly. Probably means some bad stuff, but how bad, I don't really know. Now, I think it's important at this point for me to let you guys know that I am not a professional mechanic. I do this kind of stuff for fun. I like to do it. I like to wrench on cars. And I really want to do this so that I show everyone out there who might want to own an older car or just the car of their dreams, but they can't afford to take it to a mechanic. There are plenty of forums out there and things that can help you do this. I don't know a whole heck of a lot about this engine, but the guys on the Beamer forums, they know all about this engine, and they have been immensely helpful in letting me know what the next step should be to track down why this engine runs like crap. So we're gonna try to do a leak down test, and we'll see how it works. I don't know how well my air compressor works, and I've never done a leak down test. But essentially, what a leak down test does is it, instead of testing the compression, it pushes air into the cylinder and tests how much of it leaks out. Now, that in and of itself doesn't really do much, because I already know that I've got 5 bad cylinders. What I really want to know is where the air is going, because if it's just pistons that aren't seating right or something like that, or we've got a blown head gasket, well, that's not a terribly difficult fix. But if we determine that the rings on the pistons are bad, or maybe we got a cracked cylinder head or something like that, well, that's a lot worse. The main thing is, when you do a leak down test, you have to listen to where the air is escaping from. So that's kind of what we're going to do here today. I'm going to try to listen to where the air is actually coming from so that we can determine what is actually causing the escaping gases from the car. And once we figure that out, then we're going to know a little bit more about what kind of work is going to be involved to get this car back on the road. Honestly, this is already a lot more than I was expecting, and we've already probably done more work than the car's actually worth. And for people who love cars, we don't actually do this because we think we're going to make money on the cars, although if you make the right buying decisions, you certainly can. But I got this car because I wanted it for content for the channel and because I just like it. So I don't really care. It's definitely going to cost me more than the car's worth, and I can live with that as long as you guys enjoy the content and have fun with it. So let's get to the leak down test. So first we'll test the cylinder that we think is good. All right, so we want the engine in top dead center. Shockingly, that one little thing did the trick, but I want to check. I'm going to just put a screwdriver in the port here so I can verify that the cylinder is up, and it is. It's all the way up. So this should theoretically be compressed. The valves should both be closed because I adjust the lash, as you can see. Those are loose and it's all the way up. So this should hold as much pressure as it's going to hold. Now, some loss is perfectly normal. You're going to get loss in your compression. It's just going to happen. They don't make perfect rings on your pistons. 10% loss is good or normal or really good. 20%, 30% is still functional, but less than that is bad. So now what we do, and just keep in mind, I'm not gonna use a lot of pressure here because my air compressor sucks. But if you're using a lot of compression here, you're gonna wanna put the car in gear, make sure the wheels are blocked, because it will try to move that piston. I'm not gonna put enough air in here to try to move the piston. So the first thing we do is we go ahead and fill the air into that piston. And so I'm gonna fill 40 pounds, and you can see that even so, it's losing a lot of air. So if I put 40 in, it's less than 20, and it's actually leaving pretty quick. Now I don't feel it coming out of here, but I hear it coming out of the exhaust pretty quickly, actually. Nothing coming out of the intake, nothing coming out of the oil dipstick thing, which is a good sign, and no bubbles in the water. So I'm just going to close up the valve. So you can see even the healthy valve right now is not that healthy. In fact, it's not really passable. So we've definitely got a considerable amount of compression leaving this engine. And even our good cylinder is kind of telling us that it's probably the exhaust valves. Now, one thing that does concern me about this is the valves are all the way up. So it's leaking into the exhaust valve, okay. But is it because of something else? Is the engine timed improperly or something? Was there a head job done on this before and someone put it back together improperly? I think that's possible. I mean, this head looks so clean. Let's just say it's hard to imagine that this is the original head, but you never know. Let's check some other cylinders and see if we get the same result. All right, we've got cylinder number 2 at top dead center. Make sure that's as tight as you can really get it. Plug it in right here. And let me go check on my air compressor, see what kind of pressure we got. Well, we got as much pressure as we're gonna get. So let's see what happens. So we just pull this out and we add the air. And you can already see we are losing quite a bit in this cylinder. Once again, I hear a lot coming from the exhaust manifold. Absolutely nothing coming from the dipstick. No bubbles coming up in the water tank. So once again, it seems like we're looking at an exhaust valve leak. Just check and make sure that this is not semi-open for some reason. Okay. Let's try the next cylinder. Three for three for the exhaust valve, at least as far as I can tell. Enjoying this content about this 1984 BMW 733, please let me know how I'm doing in the comments and leave a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed, please do. It really does help me continue to make this sort of content. So thanks. I think it's somewhat interesting that it always seems like it's this front exhaust manifold that's leaking air out, even though it should be using this rear exhaust manifold. But everything points towards the exhaust manifold. All right, cylinder 5. Once again, nothing in the oil is, no air coming out. Do feel a little bit of intake pressure at this point. There's air coming out of there. So I think this thing needs some valve seats. Now, wherever the air leak is up here, that's a little bit concerning. They say you're supposed to do this test with this on so you can feel if air is coming out of the top of the casing, but I don't know how you're supposed to see where the actual valves are or anything with the casing on. So if the air's actually coming out of here, which I don't feel it anywhere, but if it is coming out of here, then it's a ring problem. I still think we're probably dealing with exhaust valves and intake valves, probably a valve job. But one more cylinder. All right, last cylinder. Let's see what we got. So after doing a leak down test, everything is pointing to exhaust valve leakage. Now, I don't know what would have caused this in every cylinder, and I cannot shake the feeling that there's something off with the timing. So before I pull off the entire head, I'm going to definitely dig down and specifically verify that the timing is correct. Because if the crank is off just a couple of teeth from the spindle at the top that connects to the camshaft, I'm not saying it's gonna cause the compression loss that we're getting, but it could cause the pistons to interfere with the actual valves, which could have been a valve, which would explain everything. I'm definitely not a mechanic. I'm doing this by things I read on the forums and how to do a leak down test and following instructions as best I can. And you can do all this too. Doesn't mean I'm right. We're gonna find out because I'm basically picking my way through this whole thing. But we're gonna get it solved either way and probably pay way too much money to do it. But it's gonna be fun. Next, I'm gonna verify the timing. Gonna need a friend for that because we gotta take this hood off. Well, today's results have lifted us out of the denial stage and towards the acceptance that this engine is going to take a little more work than what we were figuring. And we really get deep into it in the next video, so you don't want to miss it. My name is Michael Fire Jr., and this is definitely for the love of cars. And I know that if you're still watching, it's because you love cars too. So go out there and drive your car, and I'll see you in the next video.